We are on the top line of page Lamed Aleph. We are being presented a principle. That would be greatly beneficial if you would focus in and try to understand the principle behind this principle. To get right in there, the way the principle is presented to us. How does it occur? How does it happen? What enables the correlationship of a koyach nefesh that is on the nefesh level? And this koyach nefesh, he mislabish, imbues itself, or is imbued into a body, and into a body, a certain element of the body, limb of the body, that is able to absorb that koyach. And then the koyach itself functions on the level of that bodily vessel, and it remains functioning as a koyach hanefesh because it has a nefesh quality, even though it is totally on the bodily level. And the Rebbe is explaining, okay, we will try to elaborate on this and to get into this because this is a phenomenal point. The Rebbe explains the what facilitates this correlationship and this total descend of the Koyach HaNefesh, which becomes in proximity to be able to relate to the bodily level. And yet remain that koyach other body level give that kind of perception that is due to the fact that even on its inception, in its original state where it is a koyach hanefesh, but it has totally nefesh qualities, not body qualities. As we pointed out, the nefesh qualities, to the best that we can, refer to it is, there is no precariousness there. There is no reaction. There is only the reality itself. But even at that level, it is still that koyach hanefesh, that particular koyach. Therefore, when this comes down into the body, this koyach can relate to those aspects of the body that correspond, that relate to this particular koyach, and they become united. At this point, there is no oddity in the fact that the moach is able to understand. That really is phenomenal. How does a male come to understand? Not only understand the instinctive element, the reactive element. How do I protect myself? How do I not understand principles which don't affect the male at all? That is due to the fact that even on its inception, on the highest level, it is that koyach. And we discussed, how do we define a koyach ha-chochmah, or any koyach in the nefesh, where there's no need for koyachs? It is reality itself. So he pointed out that this is not entirely true. That the koiches definitely contribute to the grace of the nefesh itself. The chochmah of the nefesh contributes to the nefesh. Thus, the nefesh knows itself, not by its own experience, by its own identity, but what the chokhmah tells it. That knowledge is infinitely superior to that which a nefesh knows by being a nefesh. This is what we explained yesterday. This is what's called Chochmah Stima. Chochmah Stima means completely concealed Chochmah. Yes, if it's concealed, how is it Chochmah? Chochmah has to be telling you something. That Chochmah, the real Chochmah is that it brings you that which is higher than Chochmah into higher than your Metzius, into your Metzius. That's Chochmah.
So it is telling you something.
In a very concealed way.
It's telling you now.
One second. Very good. So let us explain what we mean by the Chochmah is Timur. It's concealed, it doesn't say anything. If it doesn't say anything, how is it Chochmah? So you say, well, it does tell you something. What is the difference between this telling and the initial point where we say it doesn't tell you anything? How is it? Is it telling you or is not telling you?
Shot that it's stima to the mayach, but it's revealed to the nefesh.
Please follow me, okay? I'll give you a moshul, but I don't want you to lose this thing. Let me first give you the answer in a nutshell, in two words. Normally, talking means talking at my level, talking within the environment that I'm oriented. What is this? What is it doing here? Where does it belong? How do I get here? This is within the context where that you were involved in. If I ask you, how do you get to 770? And you tell me, what? 770 is in Brooklyn. Have I tell you anything? Or it's in America?
Let me answer the question.
I haven't that, what's that? There's not a communication. It's not in that context that you're communicating. I'm talking from a different, completely different world. Which world am I talking to? Am I talking from? I'm talking from the world I'm standing on the Empire State Building. And I'm looking at the entire world. I'm saying, oh, 770 is in America. I see Europe, Asia, it's in America. I didn't talk to you within the environment that you're asking me. Doesn't Chochmah stimulate. Chochmah normally speaks to you, it's Chochmah, it's a high, but it's still speaking within the context, within the environment that you are performing. Chochmah Timur does not speak to you in the environment that you perform. From that perspective, it says nothing. It's telling us something completely from out of this world, out of your world.
But isn't that Chochmah, even on our level, Chochmah is not. Chochmah is giving you something that's higher. It's connecting you to sort of the giver, you know, the where it's coming from.
Well, normally Chochmah Gluya, Chochmah that's an Ayin Moach.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll say to you, you know why you have a mouth? So you're able to communicate to your friend and tell him what you think. That's completely within context. That's Chochmah.
Your initial question, which was that even down here, the Maya can understand these very conceptual things. And you said that's because even the way it is in Islam, even when it's in the Nefesh, it's still Chochmah. What's the point that you're making there? In other words, it's still.
Okay. I never had a chance to finish that thing, but okay. I answered your question.
Yeah.
It is Chochmah Timur. The original Chochmah is Chochmah. It says nothing. So say if it says nothing, so why is it, how is it Chochmah? Almost the idea of Chochmah is the same, so we should say. So we had a new means to understand this. And we said, what the Gemara says, Omer Rav Yehuda, Omer Rav, or usually they say, Omer Rav, Omer Rav Nachman. Why did Rabbi Huda say that Rav said? Why didn't he say he said? Here's how things are. Rabbi Huda, do you not know what the Ayin is? Of course he knew. He understood it in its full ramifications, its full richness. Let me step back from this a little bit. The Torah says, "Bereishis bara Elokim es hashamayim ves haaretz." God created the shamayim ves haaretz. What for? Even people who don't learn the Torah, if they examine the world honestly, they say there was a God decree. There was something beyond world that created the world. What am I need the Torah to tell me now? Good question. Not only that, they insist that we are being stupid. We're not really examining our own world. We need to be told what the world is. Come on, do some experiments. Wisen up. Become smart. You say no, you don't begin to know what the truth is. The truth is that basis that they have to be told basis well to the Shmai. Then I really know it. What's the difference? You with me? Huh?
Trying.
Try hard, please.
I don't know if I'm following this thread, but okay.
This guy's following the truth, that's right. What's the difference? Whether you're being told, or you, by examination of the world, come to that conclusion? The difference is that if you come to that conclusion from the examination of the world, you have only a world-level orientation. What's the reality, prime reality of the world? So with all that knowledge, you remain completely world-bound. Doesn't tell you anything about its creator. It tells you about the world. Bereshit Bara Gimel Hashamayim V'Ha'aretz relates it directly to the creator.
If you, for example, study an author's works, can't you learn about the author himself from his
work? Well, this is what I said. It depends how you learn the author's work. If you examine, if you study the author's work, do I agree with it or I don't agree with it, then you don't have the author. Then you study the author's work. If you say, teach me, and even if I don't understand, I'm still laboring in your words, that then you have the author. This is the basis of Baruch Hashem.
It's not your experience. You're not focused on me.
You know the world from God's perspective. That was said yesterday. What is the Chochmah Shebenefesh about? A Chochmah Shtimah. The Chochmah Shtimah, the Chochmah Shtimah. And that Chochmah Shtimah is reflected in our Chochmah, also in a totally hidden manner, in a very quiet, in a very subtle sub-sound manner, it tells you that what is really going on, what is the reality that you want to know, is not what it means to you and how you're going to live through your life, but what's Hashem's intent with you, with me? What is Hashem in my life? Not me. That's Chochmah. That's Chochmah Shtimah. He can't talk to you. He can't talk to you within the functioning environment. It takes you to a completely different level of reality. What we are saying, this is completely different than reality. It's relative to the Chochmah that we are experiencing in this world. It's not Chochmah at all. It's beyond the moon. Nonetheless, that is also Chochmah. It also qualifies as Chochmah qualities, because there is an element of recognition of knowledge. And this is why that can ultimately be reduced to the point where it's mislabish in the moach and remain that element in the moach, on the moach level.
I just missed that last point. I just missed that last sentence. Can you just say that one more time?
I'm going back now to the conclusion of this principle, that even in the nefesh, this knowledge, this recognition, and this quest to know not what I am and what I understand, but what does Hashem mean by giving me my presence? What am I from Hashem's perspective? That's Chochmah. When this then goes down into the Nemesh, goes down into the Guf, into the Moyach, it remains chokhmah, but at the moach level.
Without the moach level.
For me?
What do you say, without the moach?
No, at the moach level. At the moach. Becomes at the moach level, and it remains chokhmah.
So it's revealed because it's at the moach level?
It's revealed because it's on the moach level. But it retains, it's both. Now, but our question is, how can such a supreme quality be revealed in the moach? The answer is, it's revealed in the moach in the moach in chokhmah manner. The moach is capable is a receptacle for chokhmah.
Above that, it's not on the moach level.
Above that, it's not on the moach level. This is what he slaps
us. And we don't call that revealed.
Within the nefesh itself is revealed, but not
the nefesh has mahus harufni.
That's right.
Okay.
Let us step, since time, okay, I hope communicating something. Yes, sir. Chochmah is a clear thing to us, but nevertheless it's a little bit elusive. We don't know how to grasp what is meant by chochmah. Although this is definitely what we live with moment in, moment out. But take a much lower care. The koyach of picking up this cup in your hand. How is that accomplished? Is that the koyach hayad, or is the koyach hanefesh in the hand? Go ahead.
Actually, this was the scope of my question. In the last few days, we've been detecting two types of sefer, and now we're saying there's two approaches of the word chokhmah also. Can
many approaches of chokhmah.
What?
What is the difference? Forget about what we said. What's the difference?
Well, there's a superior chokhmah related to nefesh, and there's this chokhmah mislabish
in the goof.
And what bothers me is that we call the both things chokhmah.
Correctly so. Correctly so. Because even at the highest level, it's also chokhmah. Which means in the nefesh, where there is no obscurity, there is no darkness, this is also called chokhmah. Because this is a knowledge in the nefesh that is beyond the nefesh itself.
You might think that it's not chokhmah up there, you might think it's just pure reality or something like that. What would be the havamina?
Havamina would be that since nefesh does not in any way obscure the truth, so its knowledge of the truth and itself is exactly the same thing.
So you only need chokhmah when you have a goof.
When there's a moment when you don't know, right? That's when you have to
experience.
When there is an element, of discovery, then you need chokhmah. But nefesh does not have an element of discovery because it doesn't have an element of darkness. How is it called chokhmah?
Even the fact that the nefesh is a chelik of the kamim ha'mamash, and nevertheless it has chokhmah, it's getting, it's a message.
It's a chelik of the kamim ha'mamash because the chelik of the lakab gave it chokhmah. And it's called koyach ha'chokhmah. What is the, if we try to identify the in ha'chokhmah in the nefesh itself. The nefesh is chokhmah, is elokus, is ruchni. So what is the chokhmah in the nefesh? which is beyond the mitzvahs of nefesh.
Is that, you said before, chokhmah stima?
Yes. The chokhmah in the nefesh is that this is not me at all. It's the Rebbe Shem himself. This knowledge is not because I examined anything, I experimented anything. This is the Mabish's presence. The Mabish gave me that knowledge. That. This is, like I said, in a moshul. Omar Rabbi Huda, Omar Rab. Rabbi Huda knows what Rab said. And he knows this forehand, and he knows the justification, everything about it. And yet, it remains by him a knowledge. He knows what Rab said. That's real wisdom. He does not base his knowledge on worldly experiment. World means nothing to him. What's important to him? Rab said that.
But yet, even after, there can come a time when he himself perceives what Rab said on the level of Chochmah. He doesn't need some worldly experiments.
That's right. But that is because of the influence of Rab on him. Because Breshus Bor and Kim Zeshmaim is also a posik in the Torah. You understand the implication there? Those are Chochmah on the highest level. And this in the nefesh itself is also Chochmah. This is why when it comes into the physical brain, it can relate, it can imbue itself into the brain. And it remains Chochmah on the level of the brain, but it's still Chochmah. Like we said the other day, yesterday, right? This is a phenomenal thing. A person does not enjoy food unless he sees it. What for? How do you eat? With your eyes or with your mouth? Does a dog need to see the food that it eats? When the horse is taken for a long trek, or a long trip, what do? They take a big pouch, fill it up with hay, tie it up around the horse's neck, and the horse is in the seventh heaven. Eat straight the hay from the pouch.
So all the restaurants have it wrong? All the fancy restaurants? The dim lights?
Dim light is not to enjoy your food. Enjoy your company, whatever you miss your guys.
Yeah.
So, right? Okay, this is it. Okay, have a great day.